In this video, I take the movement out of its case, sort out the problem with the chains, and oil the movement. This is a brand new cuckoo clock that I got from an auction recently. It dances on a platform, and it also has a music box in it. The chains were still factory sealed. The clock has never worked, it's never been up on the wall. The problem with it is the chain on the timeside train had come off the great wheel. And the people who made the mistake of pulling the chain in the wrong direction didn't know how to repair it. So they just put it into auction to get rid of it. And I picked it up for 180 Australian, which is the equivalent of about 85 US. This clock is brand new. It retails in Australia for $970. It's a one-day cuckoo clock that has a regular movement inside it. So what we're going to do today is we're going to remove the movement, put the chain back on the sprocket of the great wheel on the time side, and then oil the movement because it would never have been oiled, and then put it back together again, then put it on a test stand to check it, make sure it's working properly. All right, we'll start off with taking the hands off. I'll undo that knurled nut with a pair of pliers so we can get a grip on it. That's a wooden hand, actually. Take the wooden hand off. It's got a washer on top of it. Then we take out this square section here that holds a minute hand, and then very carefully we lift up the hour hand. Alright, now we'll turn the movement over, and there you can see the chains, brand new, absolutely brand new. There's the music box. You'll notice there's no dust, no dirt, no scratches on anything because it's absolutely brand new. And it's a regular 25 movement made in West Germany. Right, first thing we have to do is take the weight hooks off, all of which are very tight at the base of the clock case because they've come from the factory and it's never been used. So I'll take those off first, which won't be particularly easy to get at each of those. Actually, I'll do that offline. I don't want to scratch the case. I'll take the one of the hooks is all right. That'll be an easy one. But the other two are flush up against the bottom of the case. I've taken the weight hooks off. Now, we're going to have to take the bellows out, unfortunately. I hope we didn't have to. It's the first time I've tackled one of these platform dances and music box movements. So, I'm a bit nervous about it. There's different levers running here and there and in various places, but we have to find out how to fix it. So, it's got to be done. All right. So, we'll start off by taking the bellows lift wires off, hold them with a pair of pliers down towards the base, and then lift them up. They drop out of the bellows lift lever and they come straight out. I'll take that out. That's a high note. Now we'll get in here very carefully around the hammer and we'll take the low note out. The lift wire, the low note bellows. Back a bit. I think that should now drop out. Not particularly easy to see in there, actually. I'll get a larger pair of tweezers and see if I can hold that down. and lift that up. Almost, but not quite. I'll actually turn that back a little bit more, which might make it a shade easier, I hope, to remove it. Get over that star wheel there. Hold that down. And pull it out. There we go. Now we'll take that out. That's the low note lift lever. They're both out. So now we can take out the bellows. And the bellows are held in with Phillips head screws. So I'll lose all our chains. Remove this from the side, comes out easily. Put it into a dish. And then very carefully ease the pipe off the wall. Because we don't want to damage anything. I'll use a larger blade screwdriver. Seems to be a relatively long grab that's holding that. Thought we might have been able to push it out, but we can't. All we did was put the pipe back in again. It's virtually there, but getting very close to the dancer's platform. Push that back in. I'm thinking I might be able to leave that one there, actually. I'll put the screw back into it again, tighten it down, and I'll look at just taking the other side off. I might be able to get away with leaving the high note in. Be good if I do. The least amount of taking this to pieces, the better, as far as I'm concerned. All right, we'll go for the low note. It looks like it'll be easier to remove. Take the screw out. Then screwdriver. And prise it gently off the wall. Move up to a bigger blade one to give us, there we go. We've got to be very careful of that lift wire. That's a lift wire that lifts the tail of the bird. All right, put that aside and I'll remove this brad here. Push that out. Oh, maybe not. Seems to be pretty well in there. Nope, the head is actually driven into the wood, right? No, that's going to stay there apparently. All right, now let's see what we've got. One, two, three, four screws. I think we'll need same size screwdriver. Right, I'll take those screws out, pick them up with a pair of tweezers. That's the first one. Gee, they're tiny little screws too. This top one up here. Pick him up. Pair of tweezers. Put him aside. The next one. The fourth one's going to be fun. It's buried away very close to the music box. And that's three. Now turn the movement round so I can see where the bit more light on the subject, I think, so I can see where this screw is. It's gonna need a longer shaft on it to get down there. I don't know if that head is going to fit in or not. All right, this is going to require some work off camera. Then I'll be back. Well, that was fun. I've got the chains back on again. Now, while we've got it here, we'll oil it. The grape wheel. Another grape wheel. And the third one. A little bit much, I'll take some of that off. That's better. We'll slowly work our way up the trains. Oiling the pivots as we go. Up to the fly. And I think that's done for that side, so very carefully turn the movement over. A bit of a nervous Nelly with this one, but first time, though, we'll see how it goes. I'm very pleased I don't have to take the whole thing apart. Well, I hope I don't. Great wheel. Double oil there. And what have we got up here? There's got to be, yep, there it is. One underneath there. The second wheel. And there. Yeah. One there. And get into the pallets on there, and that's hidden in behind there, so I'll put one there. And I'll put one on the inside of the fly there, because very hard to get it the other side. Da-da-da-da-da. Alright. Alright, I think they're all done. I'll put that down here for the moment. Put the oil away. Put the oiler back into the pit. If you find this video helpful, please leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. If you would like to watch another of my clock repair videos, click on one of the thumbnails on the right-hand side of the screen.